Hello, I'm your coding here, and we'll be center aligning bootstrap navbar items like this. First, we'll see how to do this using only bootstrap classes. This is the bootstrap 5 starter template, and I've added a CSS file which will be used later. This is the bootstrap navbar I'll be using. This is the live preview. Now to get the links to the center, add the class MXAuto here. To get the navbar brand or the logo to the center, place it inside this. Looks like it's done, but on the smaller screens, it looks something like this. So to fix that, let's add this back. But we don't want this on the larger screens. So let's set this to display none, only for larger screens. And for the duplicate on the smaller screens, let's set this to display none and display it block only on larger screens. And now it's done, and that's how you center align using the display property classes by Bootstrap. We can also do this using CSS. Let's start fresh. I'll be using the same navbar. These links are part of the div navbar collapse. Here, this one. So navbar collapse has flex grow set to 1 by default. Let's set it to 0. You probably won't use navbar collapse for something else, but container fluid can be used for many other things. It's best to use your own custom classes rather than overriding the Bootstrap classes. So let's add a custom class here, say myContainerFluid. And now let's style this. Since container fluid is a flexbox, we can use justify content to horizontally align the elements within it to the center. You can also try space around if you like this look or this one, but we need to put it in the center. And it's done. But again, on the smaller screens, we get something like this. You might not want that. You can try placing everything in the center. But I'd prefer it to be on the left, like the default navbar on smaller screens. So to apply these changes only on larger screens, let's use a media query. Only for minimum width 992 pixels, which is the breakpoint for collapsing the navbar. And that's how it will look. This is the smaller screens and the larger screens now. This is how you can make it look like the navbar you saw first at the starting of this video. If you're still here, thanks for watching.